Hello, what we're going to do today is make some more. We're going to make these blocks today. And I'm going to show you exactly how we do it. First of all, I've got to move these out of the way, ready for the next set of blocks. But this is how I move the blocks. So with this, I slide the piece of wood one way and the other to release it from the blocks, take away the end blocks. These end blocks are critical. These are the same, you want these the same thickness. You want these are 2 inch. You want the blocks the same thickness as this. So when you put weight on, these will all be uniform, the same height. And then I take them off by sliding the palette knife underneath. There you go. I take them off by sliding this thing under there. Drop them on the edge and carefully putting them on here. So there's room for 10 of these on here. And I'll sit them where they've sat before. So there's a couple of marks on here, show me where they're going. Again, slide that both ways. It's all a bit damp. Get rid of the blocks. They don't want to slide. There you go. Even them out a bit. Pick it up and put it on the shelf. Put the next one down. And you do this till they're all on the shelf. So this is about 4 days after I made the blocks. There you go. So when they were made, they were about 350 grams. They're now probably still 300 grams. And they're dry when they get down to about 120 grams. So there's no great additives, or there's a bit of PVA in occasionally, but there's no oil, or it's all very friendly. They're lightweight. They only get touched now from since they've been made. They get this little move around and then they sit on the shelf until they're dry. I don't move them around. I used to move them around and turn them over and do all sorts. Now they go on the rack to dry. Which will be about 3 weeks' time. So, gives me a chance to use these on the fire at home. Anyhow, watch the rest of the video and we'll go through making some of them in real time. Some bits I'll speed up, but I'll show you a few real time how long they take. So I will get 60 blocks out of a bag of shavings. And when I say bag, this is what I call a bag of shavings. So it's only a small bag. Right, I'll sweep this up. You enjoy the rest of the video. Thanks for watching. So this has got a cap full of PVA in as well. So it's mainly mahogany and oak. So that's all this is, mahogany and oak. Going down a bit too easy. So they're going too thin. This is coming into contact with here too easy. So I've just put some more in. But it needs finer dust in it. So the mix isn't right. It's all compressing too easy. So I'll add some finer dust. Okay, that one's fatter than this one. Let's add some finer dust. If you look at the mix now, it's not as flaky. So there you can see just what it looks like. And it's just water with a cap full of PVA. Yeah, that needs filling up with sawdust. It's just too watery. This is all. Seems to be pretty much oak. It is, isn't it? Right, so this has gone down, so I'm going to put the rest of that in. Right, so as you can see, this is now replenished, so that's ready for next week. These are done. I normally only do 30, so 15 30, and they will take up the top three shelves here in that space there. So you can see that a bag will do 60 blocks, probably more than that, probably more like 80. So we've got 30 there, get another 30 out of that plus another few. But I don't want to start planing all the timber and filling that up until I've got rid of, well, I've got rid of a bag now. That will go there and be covered up, and that's ready for next week. Those will be, in 3 or 4 days' time, go on the shelf. And on, and that's how we do it.